Okay, so the final talk in this section, also from the applications track, is going to be given by Cedric Pallet, Satellite Download Management with Uncertainty and Generated Volumes. Forward and back, if you want to use it.
Thanks. So this is a joint work with several institutes. This work involves ONERA, which is the French Aerospace Lab, the CNES, which is the Spain's French agency, LAS CNRS, and the Airbus Defence and Space, which was known as Estrium a few months ago. In this work, we are considering activity of Earth-observing satellites. These satellites are flying around Earth at about several hundreds of kilometers, and their mission is to perform acquisitions of areas on the ground, to compress acquisition data on board, then to memorize data once these data are compressed, before downloading this data to ground reception stations. And this is a kind of system which we consider in this study. And more specifically, we focus on the fourth point, that is, we focus on the data download problem for these satellites. In this problem, there are several sources of complexity, the main one being the uncertainty about data volumes generated by acquisitions. The reason for this is that it is hard to predict the presence of clouds, for instance, in images. And if you have a lot of clouds in an image, the compression rate will be high, whereas if you don't have any cloud, the compression rate will be low. And this induces an uncertainty in the data volume generated after compression. Moreover, these systems involve activities whose duration depends on their start time. I will give some examples in the following. For such systems, we have some non-standard user requirements and preferences. Non-standard meaning typically non-additive, non-additive rewards. Also, these satellites are not permanently visible from the ground. That is, we don't have a permanent control over these guys. And last, physical architectures embedded on board these satellites are more and more complex. Here is an example, a typical example of a physical architecture on board an Earth observation satellite. On the right, on the left, you have the observation instruments, which is composed of several detector lines. These detector lines, when an acquisition is made, send data to data compressors. These data compressors send data to a set of memory banks where the data is stored on board the satellite. And these memory banks can be linked with download channels, which are used to download data. And data is actually downloaded using a mobile emission antenna. So mobile meaning that the antenna can be oriented towards a particular direction, and this is useful to point to ground reception stations to make downloads. Another point is that the satellites we are considering are called agile satellites, which means that they have the ability to move around their center of gravity in order to point to a particular area on Earth, which means that we have, if we consider the mobile antenna, we have to consider a mobile antenna embedded on board a mobile system, and we must do something with that. The contribution of the paper is that the usual way of building download plans for these satellites is to build download plans completely in advance on the ground. What is done is that these download plans are uploaded to the satellite, and the satellite only executes these plans. There is no onboard intelligence, at least for European satellites. And the uncertainty is handled by considering pessimistic assumptions on volumes. That is, we consider that we have maximum data volumes at execution time. In the paper, we explore another approach in which we try to build download plans on board. The advantage being that on board, we will have more information concerning the real volumes of data. We can directly observe these volumes. That is, we have less uncertainty. The challenge being that on board, we have much less computing resources in terms of CPU and RAM available. So to build download plans on board, we consider the following decision-making architecture. So this is the ground and the board. On the ground, we compute acquisition plans, because the computation of acquisition plans is a heavy process with image processing, computations, and we leave this process on ground. During control windows, that is during a window during which we can send orders to the satellite, we send the acquisition plan to the satellite, and the satellite will execute acquisition activities requested by the ground station. In parallel of that, as we said, we want to perform onboard planning of downloads. So just before windows during which we can perform downloads, these are windows during which we can see ground reception stations. Just before these windows, we will plan downloads and then execute these download plans. So, and this is the kind of architecture which we consider in this study. For this step, for the download planning step, what we do is that we plan just before group of overlapping visibility windows. So if these elements are ground reception station visibility windows, we will plan over this group based, we will plan over a restricted horizon, because as we are on board, we cannot plan over a very long-term horizon. And we will plan over the first group, then time will go on, and we'll plan over the second group, and so on. And on board, for acquisitions already realized, we consider that we take real volumes assumptions. And for acquisitions not already realized, we take maximum volumes assumptions. Because it may happen that when planning here over this group of windows, there may be acquisitions which end during this group. And we have to make some assumptions about volumes for these acquisitions. Based on these assumptions, we are able to build download plans which are directly executable, because we take pessimistic assumptions, and so plans will be executable in the end. Now let's focus on the data download problem which we have to solve. Here is an example of a download plan. In this download plan, the basic activities are file downloads. Here, in this scenario, we have five acquisitions, A, B, C, D, E. And for each acquisition generates a certain number of files to be recorded on board. This activity here corresponds to the download of the first file of acquisition A, and this file is stored on a particular memory bank on board. This file is stored on memory bank M1. This is the download of the fourth file of acquisition A, which is stored on memory bank M3, and so on. In these download plans, we can see three lines, which correspond to the three emission channels which are available on board. And we can see that we have a set of temporal constraints to be satisfied. First, if we look at temporal constraints represented by arcs in red, these temporal constraints say that download activities over a given channel cannot overlap. That is, we must have an order between download activities over the same channel. Similarly, for memory bank, we cannot read a file we cannot read simultaneously several files located on the same memory bank. For instance here, the arc in blue expresses that there is a precedence constraint between this file download, the file is located on memory bank M2, and this file download, because this file is also located on memory bank M2. So memory banks are unshareable resources in this problem. Next, all downloads must be performed during visibility windows of ground reception stations. So here, this first set of downloads is performed inside this visibility window of station S1, whereas with this second set of downloads are performed in the second visibility window of station S2. And this group must be included in the visibility windows. That is, we have time window constraints for activities. Next, if we consider successive download windows, we have some precedence constraints, because in order to go from one download window towards station S1 to another download window towards station S2, we have to point the mobile emission antenna from station S1 to station S2, and this takes some time. Last, we also have temporal constraints, such as we cannot download the file associated with a given acquisition before the acquisition is performed. So there is a temporal precedence constraint between the time point corresponding to the end of acquisition C here and the start time of all activities associated with acquisition C. And similarly, we may have some precedence constraint with a deadline, meaning that some file downloads must be realized before a fixed deadline. Another aspect of the download problem is that there are some time-dependent effects. Because first, the duration of download activities depend on the time at which downloads are performed. The reason is that the download rate depends on the distance between the satellite and the ground station. That is, when the satellite is far from the station, so download rate is low, whereas when the satellite is just above the station, the download rate is high. And similarly, for antenna moves required to point from one station to another, as the satellite is moving over its orbit, as the Earth is rotating on itself, we also have this behavior, that is the duration required to move the antenna from one station to another depends on the time at which the transition is performed. So this was for temporal constraints. We also have, to deal with the download problem, we also have a set of non-temporal constraints, such as all files associated with the same acquisition must be downloaded during the same window. Moreover, for a given acquisition, there is a set of allowed ground stations on which the acquisition can be downloaded. We also have resource constraints related to the fact that when data are downloaded, data need to be encrypted because acquisitions are requested by several users, and there is an encryption key associated with each user. And on a given channel, when successive downloads correspond to different users, you have to change the an encryption key, and the number of allowed encryption key changes is limited. This was for the temporal constraints and non-temporal constraints. In addition to that, we must also take into account preferences of users. First, each acquisition has a certain priority degree. So some acquisitions are more priority than others. Inside a given priority level, acquisitions have a particular weight. Users also want to a minimization of the information age, which corresponds to the delay between the time the acquisition is performed and the time it is delivered to the user. And last, we must ensure that there is a fair sharing between the different users of the satellite. We cannot download all activities of one user and no download activity for another one. And we end up with a multi-criteria decision problem. To deal with this problem, we use a scheduling algorithm, and the problem to be solved can be decomposed as follows. First, we have to assign acquisitions to download window. We have to decide in which download window each acquisition is downloaded. And this is a kind of multi-knapsack problem. Then we have to schedule file downloads inside each download window. And this is a kind of flexible open shop scheduling in terms of scheduling. We have unshareable resources, which are the channels and memory bank, and we have to schedule activities. We also have to check non-temporal constraints, and we have to propagate all temporal constraints in order to determine whether the plans build are temporally consistent or not. And this corresponds to we have to deal with a time-dependent, simple temporal network. As we have limited computing resources on board, we mainly use greedy or local search algorithms, so we cannot afford using a complete search on board. And in the paper, you can see the details. For the two first points, we define several algorithms. More precisely, we define two distinct algorithms to assign acquisitions to download windows and three distinct algorithms to schedule file downloads. For the first point, the two options correspond to the first option corresponds to assigning acquisitions to download windows based on the immediate reward which is won by a particular assignment, and the second option is based on the regret obtained for not making a decision. And for point two, we develop greedy algorithms which try to fill idle periods in the download plan, and also local search algorithms which identify a critical path in the schedule and try to compact schedules. And with all these options, we obtained six algorithmic variants, and we tested the six variants. Our implementation is based on a constraint-based local search library, and we use this library for checking non-temporal constraints, for propagating temporal constraints, for evaluating criteria, and also for making the definition of our search algorithms easier. Once download plans are built, we extract a flexible execution plan in the form of a partial order schedule, which allows us to obtain an executable schedule in which we have the guarantee that there will not be any resource conflicts on the use of memory banks, or conflicts in the use of emission of download channels. As for the results, we tested the approach over 1 day scenarios involving around 1,500 acquisitions, and as each acquisition generates five files, we have to deal with around 7,000 activities. We have five users, two priority levels, three emission channels to download data, five memory banks, from 3 to 23 ground reception stations, depending on the scenarios. And in terms of uncertainties, there is a ratio from 1 to 4 between minimum volumes and maximum volumes, which can be obtained on board. What we did is that we compared a ground planning with a board planning for the downloads, and the result is that it works. Ground planning works. We managed to compute download plans with short computation times, less than half a second for the best algorithms. And we managed to increase the number of downloaded acquisitions thanks to the board planning. And last, we managed to decrease the information edge, that is the distance between the time at which an acquisition is performed and the time at which it is delivered to the user on the ground. And that's it. Thank you.
So for multi-knapsack problems and knapsack problems, there are quite a few suboptimality bounds, basically, for greedy approaches. Do you have any kind of suboptimality bounds for these algorithms? Any of them?
What we did, the first comment is that it's a kind of multi-knapsack, because here one aspect is that we have conflict between bugs, because as download windows can overlap, you have conflict between bugs. So it's not exactly a multi-knapsack. The second point is that we tried to give some optimality guarantees with regard to the heuristics method which we use. That is, we have the guarantees that we are not more than two times worse than the best schedule. But to obtain these bounds, we have to relax a lot of constraints, because if we, for instance, we have to relax the time-dependent effects, we have to relax all non-temporal constraints, but we did not obtain bounds for the general problem, for the actual problem.
It sounds like the planning problem was designed so that you never have an oversubscription problem. You never acquired more data than you could possibly download. Can you tell me how close to optimal the acquisition is, in the sense of, do you have a lot of cases where you have nothing to download and you're over an opportunity? Can you tell?
Actually, there is a bit of oversubscription, because I didn't mention it, but as there is an uncertainty about the volumes generated on board, what we do on the ground is that we build oversubscribed acquisition plans. That is, we build acquisition plans, but we don't have the guarantee that we will be able to download all acquisitions. And on board, what we use is that if we want to perform a very priority acquisition, we may remove files from a less priority acquisitions. So for the acquisition execution, we also have an onboard decision rule to deal with such elements. And during some periods, over some groups, we may have nothing to download. Yes, this is true, and this is moreover, as each user, for each user, there is a set of allowed ground reception stations. It may happen that we have data stored on board, but we are not allowed to perform any download during windows of a group. In the scenario, for the 1 day scenario, over 1 day we have to consider around 40 groups of visibility windows, and among these 40 groups, among them, for 30 of them, we have to download data, and for 10 of them, the download plan is empty.
One last question, Adele.
So you've got a really fast algorithm right now, but given that you're using local search, if you had available computation time, could you use that to improve the solution?
Yes, we could. Actually, in ongoing work, this project is not over. We are trying to do that and to use a local search approach. What we did here in the paper, we used a local search approach for point two, for scheduling file downloads inside each download window. This means that we perform local search box, and we try to compact the schedules. But it appears that local search doesn't bring that much improvement. We don't have a lot of conflict between resources. And on the results which we obtained, it was not worth using local search inside each group of visibility window, inside each download window. And what we are trying to do at the moment is to use local search for the first problem, that is, in order to determine to which window we assign each acquisition. Because, yes, you are right, here, it may happen that we end the planning phase well before the group of visibility windows, and we may want to optimize the schedules. Okay.
Do the download windows share channels, or do you have to worry about that interaction?
Download windows.
But you have three channels for downloading. Do they have to be shared among, you know, if you have overlapping windows and you're going in parallel, you have to...
There is a single antenna which can be pointing to a ground reception station, so you cannot download simultaneously.
So you can't, okay.
No, it's a very directive antenna, maybe 2 degrees, a cone of 2 degrees, 1 or 2 degrees.
Thank you. So I think the plan is to be back on time after lunch. So